to be a very superstitious fight.
Dallas Stars, San Jose Sharks playing game two of their Western Conference semi.
Goaltenders are considered to be a very superstitious bunch. Flyers goaltender Marty Biron is no exception. He goes to great lengths every day to make sure he sticks to his routine, and that includes keeping his feet warm every time he laces up his skates. You don't have to take my word for it. Just check this out.
Hockey goaltenders have a reputation for being a little different than everybody else, and Flyers puck stopper Martain Biron has a theory on why that is.
It's a very lonely position to be a goaltender, so I think that everybody wants to stay away from the goaltender, not talk to him, look at him as if he had three heads or whatnot, but we're pretty simple guys. But sometimes we take one too many shots in the head. One of the things that drew me to goaltender is the fact that you can show your personality a little bit more than any other guys.
Oh, that's pretty.
Chirping against opponents and goalies, some of them like it, some of them don't. It depends how I feel.
Nah, you just missed your shot, buddy. Hey, I'm not a liar. I don't lie. I don't lie. I don't whine.
I have had my fair share of chirping with other guys.
What are you saying?
Usually when I'm in the zone and I'm focused on the game, I talk with my defenseman or my forward.
What happened in the neutral zone there?
Yeah.
Timo, if you have time, wait a second for a winger to get there.
I always said that the day that I stop having fun, the day that I stop learning and playing hockey is the day that I'm going to hang him up.
And nothing is more fun for Biron than working on his goalie gear.
You have your routine, you know, you get dressed. So every morning I come in, I open him up, and I blow in him a little bit of warm air before I put him on my feet. And some of the guys are like, what are you doing? Why do you smell your skates? I'm like, no, I don't smell them. I blow warm air in them so that they don't feel cold when I go in. But I've never really taken the sniff out of them. I'm not going to do it now either.
And a beautiful clutch save by Biron.
Catching a puck is really important for a goalie, and you want to be able to catch it with the best of it. So I like a glove that feels like you're playing baseball. And that's what I like about this glove, is that when I put it in, it feels like I'm playing second base and I'm back when I'm a kid.
Martin, you know, a magic man in goal.
What my little suture kit looks like, as bad as it might sound, this is my purse, you know? That's what women do when they can't find something. What they do, they turn their purse upside down, they shake it, and make sure that they got everything. It will disgust you, but this is what I carry with me everywhere in the league. You never know when you're gonna need a skate lace to fix a piece of that equipment. Dental floss. Not for the reason that you think. Try to break a piece of dental floss just with your bare hands. You can never do it. So whenever I need to sew a piece of equipment, I use dental floss. Nice pair of scissors that can cut about anything. These you always have to have. Or I got stuff in here I don't even know. Lubricant eye drops. Never know when you're going to have to need them. Got a toothbrush. This is for the apparent reason. If I ever need to brush my teeth, I feel like something is there, I can have a toothbrush. But, you know, that's just things that I carry around that I've had for a while. There's some science behind every madness that we have in the goalie gear, and it is something that I like to play around with, and I think about it pretty much all the time.